And another result reaction is Emphasis. The street certainly seems to be cheering Emphasis, and how, with an 11% rally on the counter. The revenues, of course, did decline sequentially for the first quarter, but the company did win a $100 million deal during the period. The DXC segment, however, continues to be a pain point. CEO Nitin Rakesh is now joining us from the United States. Nitin, thank you for joining us. Let's talk about that decline in the revenue growth sequentially. It's something, of course, that has mirrored the trend witnessed in IT companies. But on the deal win side, you have done well. So take us through these wins.
Sure, I think that's a great question, because I think we've had, I would say, last three or four quarters have been pretty good in terms of deal wins for us in the direct international business. And I think this quarter, we saw a sense of urgency creep into our client community when it came to potentially, you know, putting the trigger on some of the transformation deals that they've been looking to execute on. And I think since the COVID crisis has been a major accelerant in all things digital, that's definitely helped in accelerating some of those closures. I think besides the closures, the pipeline is still fairly healthy. So given that we had a very strong Q3 and Q4 and now Q1, I think that's definitely tells us that this isn't a one-quarter or one-off event. And while Q1 has been a record in terms of TCV wins, it's well above the last trailing four quarters average by almost 40%. We do believe that this is something we can sustain. So I think this year is likely to be a fairly strong TCV year for us. And I think our conversion ratio from TCV to revenue growth has been fairly good as well. So from that perspective, I think we're definitely very pleased with the fact that this gives us a pathway to actually bringing growth back starting Q2 on a sequential basis. You know, yes, you're right, we had 12 quarters of sequential growth before the current COVID crisis hit, but we do believe we'll get back on the sequential growth path starting Q2 21 itself.
The DXC business continues to be a bit of a pain point, and it accounts for 20% of your revenue. So how are you dealing with that? How are you de-risking this segment?
Yeah, I think we basically gave some disclosures last quarter about the fact that we had a six-quarter runway till the MRC ran out, and that backstop was about $50 million a quarter. So I think given that we do have some runway before we need to continue to find ways to de-risk, what we've really been doing is we've been using growth around DXC to kind of find a way to deal with that concentration issue. And I think from that perspective, this quarter has been obviously very good, and we expect the next couple of quarters to actually work well as well. Having said that, we still believe that there's a strong, partnership approach that we've taken with DXC. Given just some of their business portfolio and the exposure they've had, they've obviously seen some disproportionate impact on the overall business, and that's reflected in some of the numbers you've seen in our DXC revenue as well. But given that we've seen some very large wins, given that we do believe we have a pathway to de-risking that and not letting that become obviously this growth dilutive at this point in time, but we still have a pathway to growth for not just the next three quarters, but actually for the full year as well. So I think from that perspective, finding ways to grow around it, and of course continuing to stay focused on being a strategic partner is the primary execution roadmap that we've laid out for ourselves.
PAT margins declined this quarter, while other IT companies managed to expand margins, primarily aided by lower costs. So what hit your margins, and was there pricing pressure? What were the factors?
So I think at an EBIT level, we've actually held pretty steady. What happens between EBIT and PAT is a combination of certain one-times and exceptional items that you saw in the March quarter, especially, we called out the 2.30 rupee EPS reversal that we got due to a tax write-back. So from that perspective, I think that was a little bit of an exceptional quarter. And second thing, obviously, is tax rate and other income. But I think from at an operating level, the operating margin is actually fairly stable and in line with where we had guided. And we expect to operate in the 15.5 to 16.5 operating margin range for the full year 21 as well. What happens below the line, obviously there is some efficiency that we can bring back, whether it happens to be treasury operations or tax optimization. We'll continue to work on that.
All right, before we let you go, if you could just share with us an outlook for the rest of the year in terms of growth, in terms of demand.
I think I will call for the fact that we've seen growth bottom in Q1. even in a quarter like Q1, actually on a year-over-year basis, we've still seen about 4% growth in constant currency terms for the whole company, despite all the puts and takes and headwinds of the quarter itself. So we do believe that on a sequential basis, we will start, we will see growth coming back in Q2. And of course, that if you grow in Q2, we'll still be on a YoY basis on a growth path as well. So I think for us, we've clearly seen the headwinds related issues behind us and growth having bottomed in Q1. Getting back on the sequential growth path in Q2 and also finishing full year with a growth metric.
All right. Thank you so much, Nitin, for joining us and breaking down your numbers. 11% rally meantime for an emphasis. Okay, let's move on now.